Hello everybody and welcome to another episode in the Jack Wall Let's Play Euro Truck Simulator 2. And again we jump in, although it looks like I'm on a current job from, yeah, okay, I am. So we hop in and drive. I must be pulled over somewhere since the last time I played, and as usual I can't remember, but en route to Strasbourg with a load of rubber tires. Somewhere in the back of my memory, I think I remember this. So, let's see, right, yes, I was driving a blue Mark with nothing fancy. It's a low roof sleeper, and okay, alrighty then, so let's start this up. My sleeping I have 2 hours and 35 minutes of a stop. Yeah, maybe it makes sense for me to actually go asleep here. Yeah, I believe it does. Yeah, it does. So, do you really want to cancel the job? No, I don't. I don't really want to cancel the job. I actually want to go asleep. How does one do that? Drives forward and then one drives back. I need to wait for the little icon to come up. Of which I don't have it. There we go. Stop the engine and rest. That's what I wanted to do. Morning time is here. We can start again. And here's the schedule away. Nothing more complicated than that. Alright, off with us. Clear there, so oops. Okay, so it's a lovely morning, 10 o'clock Wednesday, and we have plenty of time left. 4 hours and 37 minutes of driving, so not going to be too difficult to get this delivery done and pick up another 14,000 as we maneuver our finances closer to being able to buy our own truck. Okie dokie, lemon squeezy. Okie dokie, lemon squeezy. It's Thursday today in the real world, and I'm happy that the day is over. Really, I had a fairly involved day at work today. Yesterday I was preparing a lot for it, and yeah, it's one of those days that happens every so often, of course, and you know, ultimately they're important days, but they're a lot of stress, I think, the word to use for change. I'm pretty good with stress. I don't tend to suffer from it that I'm aware of anyway too much. Although I think I do something from it a little bit, and I certainly was something from it during yesterday in preparation. The preparation wasn't just done yesterday. Been kind of building up to it for a little while, but kind of yesterday was the last check, you know, is everything done, are we good, are we good, are we good? That seemed to be the question, are we good? And we were good, and the proof is in the pie, so to speak, but and I gotta eat the pie, and today was a long old day, which is over, and we're done, and I'm thankful about that. I was worried that one little aspect, maybe not so little, but one part of the project was going to be a big problem, and yeah, it was really good, because it wasn't a problem. In fact, it was pretty much well under control, and some other people who are involved in the project were on top of it fully, and yeah, very, very relieving actually to realize that this was properly being managed. So tomorrow is Friday, and I'm actually going to work from home tomorrow. I'm not going to go to the office. Plenty of don't have to go into the office and battle through traffic on the way home, because there is a school holiday period that is starting, and the expectation is that traffic is going to be rather busy. Plus, of course, we roll over onto the weekend of, according to police upon intention, we roll over very soon over the next couple of days into July. So I'll not have to battle traffic on the way home tomorrow, and just generally take the easier route. I'm lucky insofar as with my job I am occasionally able to log in via the internet here at home, and that reminds me there's something else I need to do, and do my work. And I've set up a little office space in the room here, so that, you know, I can go to work. Even though I'm at home, I'm actually not at home watching TV or chilling out. I'm at home and I'm working. And I tend to, you know, do my normal thing. I'm just going to be interrupted for a minute, so I'm going to have to ask you to bear with me, and I'll be back in a second. Okay, I am now back. Hopefully that interruption wasn't too much of a deal. Somebody at the door kind of scenario. So anyway, climbing up these serpents. Well, I haven't been on this road before, but I don't recall, and we're climbing quite nicely up here. And we have about 23 tons, well, 23 tons of wheelset tyres. So we have a little bit of a convoy behind us, but don't worry about that too much. We'll haul up. I do like the scenery again in this game. Strasbourg, all around the pass of the Alps and whatnot. So we have a few more little switchbacks to negotiate, and 2 hours and 56 minutes of driving, so everything is going quite well. Steinbruch. So 50, and some fairly tight turns here, so we should be able to just let her pull herself around. But she's going to accelerate now on this hill, so we need to kind of keep a little bit of control, because this one's quite a fairly, it's a whole 180 degrees of the pull, so. And I don't have a motor brake on this model. Got to do it all on my foot. There's a man truck coming up on my clear. I have. Here's another one. And there's a Volvo. I like the Volvo from the outside as well. I think, you know, I'm tending towards the Volvo a little bit more. For some reason. I've driven a few Volvo cars, and I've always found them to be a little small inside. I'm not the biggest guy in the world, but I'm 6'1 and about 95 to 100 kilos typical. I'm always found the Volvo's pretty small. Not so small that you're claustrophobic now or anything like that, but not so spacious inside. But in this game, I think the modeling of the Volvo trucks are, but the one that I've driven, which I think was an FH16, and it was quite a powerful engine and had a lovely sound, and the inside was nicely laid out. And the inside of this Merc is nicely laid out as well, and it's a pretty basic model, in fairness. Haven't driven the Scania yet, and I have high expectations there. Keep repeating myself with that. as a Majestic with a very lovely and stupid looking logo on the front. Maybe I need to download the logos, green logos mod, and put that on. Maybe we'll set that as a goal for later. The moment the game is stuck, you can call, and a nice maneuvering there in your BMW. It's lovely driving. Yeah, have an accident there on the apex, and where am I? Only right in the middle of the apex, and boom, I'm involved in the accident as well. Thank you very much, you dumbass. Right, clear on the mirrors, and whoa, we're way too fast here, so I need to knock off a lot of speed quickly. And that is a junction, Jack. Whoa, okay. Doofus, that's me. So here am I criticizing the Mercedes, the BMW driver, or whatever it was. In actual fact, I'm just about to do something even more stupid. Although I think the BMW driver went straight through as well. But making him out to be wrong does not cover up the fact that I was almost wrong there. I was able to put the brakes on, I was able to stop. But for a minute there I wasn't such a good driving. Two hours and this load will be delivered. I haven't been on the SES website in a little while to find out what the latest and greatest is in terms of the expansion and the updates. I'm assuming, although maybe this is a false assumption, I'm assuming that Steam, through which I bought this game, will serve the update. You know, if it's rolled out as an official update, it would be the method by which I would expect to get it. But I have no idea on what the schedule is for it. I expect that there is an expansion to the map. And probably a list of bugs and error reports that have been submitted will get addressed. Excuse me. There has been obviously some updates already, and those updates have come down fairly positively with the community. Again, making note of the friendliness towards the modding community within Euro Simulator 2, and now SES is serving that core group of people, without whom we wouldn't have some of the fantastic mods that we have. It says, even though we're not using any of them yet. I think a map expansion is something that everybody is looking for, particularly those that have played the game, since it's release and have played the game for much longer than I have. There's a lot of people that have explored the map fully. In my first little career on the other computer, I think I covered a little over 50% of the map. But I do recall driving significant portions of the same section of the map repeatedly in my quest of money, building up my bank account so that I could expand my business. And I quite enjoyed that, so there was a little bit of grinding, you could say, that was going on. Jeez and peas, man. These AI don't mind driving around blind corners. So I'm probably going to do something similar within this Let's Play, frankly, because that's what I want to do. And you know, in my aspiration, excuse me, my aspiration is to run a garage that is outfitted with each of the various different types of truck, and that affords me the ability then to maybe switch between various different models as when I want to do 60 coming in, but he's going to come to a stop, so I need to drag it back down. The truck line through, but there we go. Now we are going here to the left, so I'll stick on the semaphore, and can't go to the right anyway, it's blocked off. So I guess that's where the expansion map would just plug on to the end of that, right? Who knows? We're at Strasbourg, 47 minutes away, so this delivery is not going to take too much longer. Daddy. So we'll be there in no time. We do have to do a little bit of a... How's that supposed to be? I probably need to be in the other lane. Get over into the other lane now. I will too, because the right lane takes it off to the right. And the left lane is the one that will bring me what looks like underneath them. Up and over. Under this and then up around and back on ourselves. So I'm going to carry as much speed without being ridiculous in as possible. I'm running pretty low anyway, but this truck is going to start struggling by the time I get up here. I'm beginning to struggle already. Dropping down to the gear D6. Should pull out with D6. Clear roads, so we're safe. Yeah, we're very much in the region now, 15 minutes to deliver. I think we have loads of time in our hands. Yeah, we have 5 hours remaining. So we're good, we're good. And obviously in the last video I had made that decision to stop. But I need to stay out. Shocking, lame as that. I'd made that decision to stop. I was really, really tired in the real world. Split this into two videos, at least two recorded videos. I may join them together. I probably will, depending on the length. Or I could put them in a separate video. That's quite long enough. My upload rate with my ISP is not super awesome. Smaller videos, shorter length videos, have a, you know, they're just a little more manageable. I do need to have a conversation with my ISP and say, what's with this very, very poor upload? Just do a little bit of comparing, competition, finding out if there's anything that's better offered. My download speed is pretty good, but I'd be prepared to double, you know, take a step up on my download speed. Green car, are you going to come past me? I'd be prepared to take offer them the ability, the opportunity to charge me double for the next package up. Assuming that the next package up carry the better upload. Take advantage of the download at the moment. So, I am not living in the middle of the center. Very much within the last mile of the exchanges. But I will be able to avail of... I think I need to go here for now. I will be able to avail of 16 megabits. Don't do that. Okay, make it around. Thank you. I will be able to avail a 16 megabit download. The upload is limited very much to, like half a meg, not even half a meg. I'm getting about 300 megabits upload a month, which, as you can tell, for big YouTube videos, it's pretty painful. My old place of living, old ISP is really outdated. 2 megabits. That was quite nice. And I never used any of it because I didn't need to use any of it. Then, now the mirror is not giving me an awful lot of light. My head is with the index and backing up, and I get green there, and I'm going to take it too. So that hopefully was good. Pays 12 and 7 and 1, so 14,000, and should bring me up a level almost as well. Splendid. So I'm now an enthusiast. Long distance is going to be again, absolutely. Thank you very much. Okay, well that was the last part of this session. So go handy and catch you the next time.